Researchers were at MSU recently testing the filtration system for a hot water drill. The drill will be used to melt through almost 3,000 feet of the West Antarctic Ice Sheet. MSU ecologist John Priskew is the acting chief scientist on the project and has conducted research in Antarctica for more than 26 years.
So we want to drill through the ice sheet, and we have to make a big hole. But in doing that, there's people at the surface, we're handling drills, we may introduce organisms. So you got to go back. Antarctica is like this sterile environment to some degree. It's by sterile, I don't mean there's nothing there. But what's there is Antarctic life. To be good stewards, we want to keep it clean.
So this is the pump filtration system for the Antarctic ice drill. And the purpose of the Antarctic ice drill is to drill through the ice sheet and to find life down under the under ice lakes. We need to filter that water very, very carefully. We do that through a 2-micron filter, which filters out the large dirt molecules and sediments and things that we might find in the ice. After the 2-micron, it gets filtered to the 0.2-micron filter to filter out any smaller particles that we might find in there. And after the 0.2, we go through 2 levels of ultraviolet filter system, which kills off any of the little bugs or bacteria that we might find on our way down the hole to the lake below.
Researchers plan to collect microbial samples from the subglacial Lake Willens.
We want to collect samples from down there and bring them up here and test these hypotheses that we've posed. How do the organisms live? What's their diversity, biodiversity? And we can't do that if we're measuring our own contamination. So we want to keep everything as clean as possible. So when we bring it up, we know we have a pristine sample. When we get data from it, we know that it's data from Antarctica and not from our own contamination. Once we've collected our sample, we're going to take the drill out and let it freeze. And it'll be a clean hole and freeze, and we're going to move into our next sampling site and do it again and do it again. Now, importantly, when we drill, this filtration system is going to be attached right to the drill, and it's always going to be filtering that water. And we have sampling ports all through it. It's got 7 sampling ports. We are going to be sampling those ports over time when that drill's running to ensure that it's clean. The ice is 2 miles thick, and there's a record, it's a million-year-old record in certain places, at least in Antarctica, of climate. And we can see CO2 and the little tiny bubbles in there, and we can get temperature out of it. And carbon, we can tell when there are forest fires. We can see the industrial age. We can see it all. It's there. It's this open book. It's this history book. Okay. Every year, there's a couple more centimeters of ice goes down, it has the record. Every year, 20 million years of that, and it builds up. This drill, is a step in a new direction. It might enable us to get faster into these systems, learn more about our climate as we need to learn more and more about it.